devastated. Gutted, in fact. I just got back from Auntie Betty's funeral. It's not so much the loss of her, when she was in her 80s after all. No, it was what happened there that's floored me. It was my gran, Betty's sister. She's the one who's upset me. We were by the graveside, and she pulled me gently towards her and she said, Raymond. I haven't been Raymond to anyone but the taxman and the doctor's surgery since I was 10. Raymond, she said, when are you going to shave off that ridiculous beard? It makes you look 20 years older. I was stunned. And this is the family matriarch giving me a body blow I hadn't fully anticipated. It'd be like the late and dear departed queen telling Philip to quit the wisecracks. I've worn this beard since my 20s. I've nurtured it over 25 years. I use only the top of the range products to maintain it. I spent an hour trying to get the Bluetooth to work. I don't think I would have got that promotion to call centre manager without it. And haven't looked back since. And I'm sure it was that which finally ensnared my Tracy. I could tell she enjoyed the challenge of finding my pursed wet lips beneath that bushy exterior. And it's done a decent job of covering up my acne. Gran, on the other hand, has always said that it's like kissing a coconut doormat. It's why Grandad had to make do with a fluffy sideburn. All right, Gran, I said. I'll shave it off for your funeral. And she smiled that endearing grand smile and said, that'd be lovely, dear. And proceeded to drop a red rose into Auntie Betty's grave.